Once more, please. Violins, brighter, stronger. And the horns, please.
It was not the violins, it was his wife. Mm-hmm.
Ready? Once more, please, same place.
No, 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 it's been a long rehearsal, Corvin. I think your wife should have a chance to relax a little before her debut.
You're shivering, Elena. Have some champagne.
No, thank you.
Why are you so nervous about your debut? You'll be the perfect Marguerite. When the audience sees you, they will understand for the first time why Faust refused the devil's offer of riches and glory and asked only for the pleasure of a young mistress.
Baron, my husband is waiting.
Splendid. Good practice for him.
Please excuse me.
Leave now and say goodbye to your career in my opera house. Believe me, Elena, my pleasure is the only thing I take seriously.
I'll kill him.
It was my fault. I'm just not good enough.
You are good enough. You are a splendid singer. You say that about everything. What can I do to encourage you? Come on, let's try.
No, I can't.
Elena, please.
No, not now.
Come, now. Now you have to get it. You can, believe me. You can. Once more. Feel the space around you. Be calm. Once more.
Oh, dear!
You see? You see? You can do it. You're wonderful if you believe in it. When I tell you you are good, you are good. You have everything you need. Now stop worrying.
Joy with you in a few months than I knew in my entire life. You took a dusty old bachelor and made him into a...
Dusty old bachelor. Oh, Sandor, I love you so much. But what if I disgrace you?
You won't.
Expensive.
I'm an artist. The greatest opera singers hire my clerk. You lead the orchestra, but I lead the audience.
She'll need encouragement only at the beginning.
Don't tell me how to do my job. I have perfect timing. I'll start the applause just when she wants it. Never too early to spoil her last note. Never too late to leave her in cold silence on stage. With Balazs working for her, she doesn't need to sing up a storm. I provide the thunder and lightning. There she goes, like clockwork. She wants to go out every evening at this time, unless it's raining. Hates the rain, you know.
Your hand is trembling. All great singers are nervous in their dressing rooms. That's a wonderful sign. The moment you go on stage, you'll be calm and superb. Come, wear this until the curtain rises. Trust me. You'll have a triumph tonight. You look beautiful.
Little talent and even less of a voice was forced to sing out in the upper register. What her audience heard was the desperate crowing of an amateur singer who needs a chorus to drown out her screeching voice.
Dressing room. When I went home, she wasn't there, so I hoped she would be here.
She'll be fine, Shandor. Please don't worry. Caruso was so nervous in his New York debut. The audience cheered him too. She's not as fragile as us. Singers are strong. Tomorrow she'll be fine.
Mr. Corwin. A pleasant surprise. What can I do for you?
I've read your biography on Brahms. Brilliant work. Excellent. Definitive. That kind of music scholarship is rare these days. You should be very proud of it.
Oh, thank you.
Why were you so cruel to my wife?
It pains me to write unfavorable reviews, but I'm obliged to tell the truth. Her debut was dreadful. Of course, if she improves on future performances, I'll be happy to praise her. Next time she sings, eh?
There will be no next time. She's dead.
Oh, I'm sorry. What happened?
You murdered her. Your review appeared less than 1 hour after her debut. You couldn't wait to destroy her.
I didn't write it. It was the Baron Hunyadi. I can prove it.
Then prove it.
See, it's written on his own stationery. Your wife offended him. He's a dangerous man. I couldn't disobey him.
I want your written confession of this conspiracy to destroy my wife. Write it. Write it. I, Oscar Krauss, hereby confess that I did conspire with the Baron Hunyadi to destroy the career of Elena Corwin. I do admire your work. The way you encourage our young composers like Bartok deserves admiration.
But it was accurate. I wrote exactly what happened. What more do you want? Oh, of course, you want it written on my own letterhead. I keep this handy to tame wild tenors. Opera would be wonderful if there were no singers. Your temper is nothing compared to some Neapolitan who thinks I've insulted his Pagliacci. I've never had to use this on a tenor, but I will on a conductor. Now get out! I've work to do. Caruso will be appearing here in 2 weeks, and I've wasted enough time on the crazed husband of a third-rate prima donna.
I'm sure you would like to write a review about Caruso.
Thank you. Made the most thorough search of the opera house, but it's nowhere on the premises.
My friend, an exceedingly valuable organ does not simply vanish into thin air. I am telling you, it has been stolen.
But we've questioned everyone. Guards, carpenters, orchestra, singers. No one.
No one again. No one indeed. That is the same no one who's been stealing everything from stage properties to the jewels around our patrons' necks. Not to mention detailed plans of the opera house from right here in this office. And you have no clue, no theories, just this ghost, this phantom.
Sir, you employ 80 musicians, 100 people in the chorus, engineers, painters, carpenters. You got 3,000 doors, 8,000 keys, and more stairways than there are police to patrol them. It's impossible to guard this place if you mean to keep it open for public performances.
You think that I should close the opera?
No, my friend. No. Absolutely not. But you will increase the guard.
Madame Bianchi, is it possible when you finish the aria to gaze at the jewels, not at the audience?
Of course not. I must acknowledge their applause.
In my productions, madam, we don't stop for applause until the final curtain.
Ridiculous.
Madame Bianchi, may I remind you that opera is musical drama, not a concert in costume for singers with trick voices.
You say that I have a trick voice? That I am a freak.
You have a charming voice, madam, but...
Hartnell, you can go to the devil. Puzzi, Amori, isn't it bad enough that I must sing with a chorus of yelping puppies, that they give me a hideous costume to wear, a wig that looks like a wig, and says that are 100 years old, but worst of all, they import an arrogant English director to abuse me.
You insisted that I should leave Covent Garden to come to Budapest. You begged me to come.
They should have warned me that you hate great artists.
I love artists. When their talents are as great as their egos.
Hartnell, please.
Lila, the throat spray!
She's a sensitive, warm-hearted woman.
Rashida, warm? If she sang Aida, we could all ice skate down the Nile.
Be nice to her, for once.
Look, Baron, if you'd like to take over this production, I'll gladly step down.
No, thank you. I fear my personal relationship with Madame Bianchi might inhibit my critical judgment.
Your personal relationship is interfering with my work.
Oh, listen to me.
All right. Understudy auditions in 5 minutes.
What the devil for? Brigida's never ill.
Because I can handle her more easily if she knows there's a replacement waiting in the wings.
All right. Have your own way, Englishman.
Take my turn. I'll wait. Let him hear you before he gets too irritable.
You are very kind, Marie.
Thank you. Next, please.
She can't sing well enough to play Marguerite, and you know that.
Her voice is better than it sounds.
I understand.
Thank you. Next.
Maria Gianelli.
You're Italian?
My parents came from Italy, but I was born in America. But you can't get anywhere in opera unless you make a name for yourself on the continent, so I came to Budapest, and I...
Have you prepared something to sing?
Before I sing, I'd just like to tell you how honored I am to have this chance. I've always admired your productions, Mr. Hartnell, and the thought of being in your Faust, my favorite opera, why...
I doubt if you've seen any of my productions, and your enthusiasm for Faust displays a remarkably undeveloped musical taste. Oh, it's certainly a popular favorite, but hardly a work of genius. Just a few popular tunes concealing this tattered old drama about this miserable old man who sells his soul to the devil for the love of this girl, whom he then proceeds to drive mad. Now, are you going to drive me mad, or are you going to sing? Thank you, Miss Ginelli. That'll do. You can go to wardrobe and get yourself fitted for Marguerite's costume.
She is charming, Hartnell. Absolutely charming.
Let me see the garden set.
My Elena. Now I have my Elena again, you see. I always knew I would find her again. We'll work hard together with her. And you have to work too. Her triumph will be my revenge. My revenge.
So, where were we? Ah, yes, you're here by the spinning wheel, singing. Then you rise restlessly, you go to this house over here, and on the doorstep you see the bouquet of flowers that Siebel has left you, and beneath it you spy the jewel box. You pick it up, you raise it, and you cry out in delight.
Ah, je ris de me voir si belle en ce miroir.
Exactly. Then you pick up this mirror inside the casket, you admire yourself. That shouldn't be difficult for you. Then Auntie comes in, you chat a bit, and then Faust and the devil come through the garden gate. Got it?
May I try it while I sing?
No, we don't have time for that.
Why? Are you afraid?
Of what?
The opera ghost.
Ghost? What are you talking about?
Everyone knows this opera house is haunted.
Oh, rubbish.
Even the cleaning ladies won't work here alone at night.
I know all about opera ghosts. Every opera house has at least one. Whenever a tenor spits his trousers or a soprano goes off key, it's the opera ghost again. Paris, Milan, even Covent Garden has its ghost. I hope you too are not going to find a supernatural reason for your mistakes. Good night, Miss Ginelli.
Special rate for an American.
Well, what about English? Anyway, no thanks, not tonight.
I know what Englishmen like.
May I walk along?
Oh, listen, I said no. Oh, forgive me. I was thinking about the production. I work as I walk the streets.
So do they.
Surely, a beautiful young lady shouldn't be out on these streets alone.
No, my lord. I am not a lady, nor yet a beauty. Marguerite's speech when she first meets Faust.
So you've learned the role already?
In English and French.
My word. Aren't you a little chilly?
No.
Oh, I thought you might be with all that naked ambition showing. A beggar with white gloves. How elegant.
You've never been poor, have you?
No.
That's obvious.
Listen, we seem to have got off to a bad start. May we rehearse the scene again?
May I walk with you?
By all means. Now, tell me about yourself. Thank you. That was lovely. Thank you so much.
Thank you for the
time. Goodness, a genuine starving artist. Mm. You know, most pretty girls in the chorus find themselves a rich patron to help them get by.
You mean take the easy way?
I may be ambitious, but I won't go to bed with a man just to advance my career. It's too hard to vocalize lying down.
So you've kept your virtue unsullied.
In most great operas, the virgins have the worst parts.
Remember to breathe. Good. Now again.
Die. 'Twere no bad thing if prima donnas died before they sing. Orpheus. Mannaggia. Vaya. Dimmi forse bella se mirò. Dimmi forse bella se mirò. Visto tu.
Hey, no, you're rushing it still. Now, if you try that passage slower, you'll find that you have much more...
Off that stage and out of this theater now!
Madame Bianchi, what's wrong?
Miss Machiavelli! This conniving slut sent me a note.
Swans sing before they die. 'Twere no bad thing if prima donnas died before they sing. Signed Orpheus. But did you send this?
No, she is lying. She is this Orpheus.
You've no reason to suspect her.
Every day while I am rehearsing, she sits out there squinting at me. La jettatura.
What?
The evil eye. She has it. What she lacks in talent, she makes up for in witchcraft.
That is medieval nonsense.
Either she is dismissed, or I am leaving.
Maria, tell Madame Bianchi why you watch her rehearse.
I'm only trying to learn.
You cannot learn musical genius.
But I can learn from your mistakes.
You have a suggestion as to what I should do with my voice?
Since you ask, if I were you, I'd have it pulled.
I never want to see her in this theater again!
Mask frightens you.
Who are you?
The mask protects you.
What do you want? No, don't.
I'm not here to steal your pitiful savings. I'm here to help you, to make you a great singer. You have a natural gift. Your voice is uneven. But I can correct that. Listen to this voice. It can be yours. This key. It opens the door to a place near the opera where you'll find everything you need while you're studying. Your hand is trembling. That's a wonderful sign. Great singers are always nervous. these clothes while we are rehearsing. What you wear outside is your own affair.
That's wonderful. Nobody in the company would believe I live here.
No one will know. No, these are the rules of the house. You will tell no one about me. You will bring no one to this place. You will devote your day to our lessons. The nights are your own. Now we begin.
So, welcome back.
You mean I got it?
Yes. Now, all you have to remember, apart from not stumbling over the scenery or tripping over the music, is that you are not a prima donna, you are Marguerite.
Why didn't you come by to comfort me after I was dismissed?
I was frightened.
What?
Of you. Oh, it's such a bother caring for someone. So much easier just to care for one's work.
I'm lucky for you, I'm part of your work now. After my debut, you can take me back to London. I insist that you direct all my operas.
Oh, good Lord. So, at last you found that easy way, huh? And I'm it.
You easy? You're the most difficult man I've ever known.
Oh? More than the, Baron Hunyadi? Huh?
It's him, isn't it? Who's been keeping you? Then who? Who paid for those gowns, for your singing lessons?
I have a friend.
What's his name?
I don't know. You never told me.
You expect me to believe that? Of course it's Hunyadi.
No, it's not.
I just want you to finish with him.
Why is it everyone's telling me how to live?
Because it's quite obvious that you don't know how to behave honestly.
I told you the truth. If you don't believe me, I can't help that.
Allow her to be distracted from her task. Stay away from her. Stay away from her, or you will die.
Miss Ginelli, what was that supposed to be?
I'm perfectly on pitch.
Don't you understand? You're in prison for killing your child that you bore Faust. You're waiting to be led out to the gallows. You cry out to God to save you from Faust and the devil, and you perform like a fashion mannequin calling a cab to take you to the hairdresser's.
Please, may I try it again?
I just don't think you can do it.
But I have a great director who can help me.
Now listen, in opera, there are no great directors without great singers performing for them, and you're not one of them yet. You're just not ready. I shall advise the Baron to postpone your debut.
How can I improve if you react with such anger every time I make any mistake?
Because I can't help it. When singers are not as good as they should be, I want to throw them bodily off the stage. So get off my stage until you learn how to perform on it.
He's up. I have the final say who appears in my production. And I can arrange for the reviews. La Gianelli, embezzling new star at Opera Galaxy.
Can't you be more original?
Yes. If your new friend does not appear, I would like to take you home.
I came here alone, and I plan to leave alone.
That may be very unwise. It could be a great help in your career.
Baron, you're famous for your help, but I plan to become a great singer, not a great mistress.
Should you change your mind, my motor car will be waiting outside.
See him again.
Of course not.
If you ever see him, Maria, he will die. If you see any other man, he will die. He will be with me forever.
Castle Hunyadi.
You offered to drive me home.
Can't you dispense with this tedious display of chest?
Let me out of here.
Who are you? Where's my driver? Where are you taking us?
What is it that you wish from me?
To avenge the death of Elena Corwin.
I'm sorry. I don't understand.
Remember.
Oh, stay.
Sandor Corvin. But that's not possible. He's dead. But if you are Corvin, why have you waited all these years to... I don't understand.
I had no pleasure of that little tart.
If you kill me, what will you have? A moment of futile satisfaction. Let me live. And I will bring honor to your wife's memory. I will make Maria the star Elena should have been. Consider my offer, Corvin. It will make her immortal.
Immortal. Let him go.
Bravo. Lovely, Brigida. Marvelous.
I thought I was a little sharp. Not much, but a little.
You were splendid.
Are you saying that because you are frightened I will run away again? I told you it was nothing but a crise de nerve. Now I know it was nothing but a harmless backstage trick. Nothing could get me to cancel my appearance.
Good. Now, are you up to rehearsing the prison scene?
But of course, darling.
Take that back flat out.
Did he tell you what his plans were last night?
Baron Hunyadi and myself rarely discussed anything, apart from details of the opera production.
I know there was little love lost between you.
You're not suggesting that I'm a suspect in his death, that I attempted to strangle myself at the Turkish bath?
No, sir. There were witnesses to the attempt.
Inspector, listen. We know the Baron's dead, but Maria Giannelli may still be alive.
I doubt that. She was last seen leaving the artist ball with the Baron. Whoever killed him probably disposed of Miss Gianelli as well.
But why?
Fear that she might be able to identify the killer.
But why would he attack me?
That's a question that still needs an answer.
Drop that in.
Watch out for that paint.
I am not surprised. Faust always been a bad problem. Remember that poor girl who made the debut in it and drowned herself?
Oh, who could forget her lovely little thing? And that poor husband of hers, the way he carried on, accusing the Baron and killing the critic.
What was his name?
Ah, sir, nowadays I'm lucky to remember my own.
Anton.
Nem,
wasn't he?
Sandor, Corvin Sandor. I never liked him.
What happened to him?
What a bastard.
You know, some say that his body was consumed in a fire. Others say that he drowned. Poor man. Never I saw a fellow so much in love.
Oh, Lila, crazy in love he was, remember?
You know that Gianelli girl, she looked a little like his wife. Same big brown eyes, silky hair, and sweet voice.
They could have been sisters.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
That's wet paint. Look out.
Have I been here?
2 days. They're rehearsing up there. You won't be needed at the opera anymore. Brigida is back. Hartnett has replaced you.
Where am I?
Just below the opera house. Where no one can find you. Don't try to escape. There is no way out. You would never find a way. The doors are locked. You could even scream. No one would hear you. You see? No one can hear you. I must protect you, or you would suffer like poor Elena. You're not ready to face the world alone. This is your home. Your refuge. Your sanctuary.
I want you to examine this signature here. Now, you see? Now, this is the last time that he signed for his wage after an opera performance. And look, note the S in Shandor. Now, this here is the note that Brigida received. Swans sing before they die. Look, the S and the I are the same in both examples of handwriting. And the signature, Orpheus. Look, the or is identical to the or in Shandor. Look!
Yeah, many people have similar handwriting. Janos, leave some for Papa.
Shandor Corvin is alive. It was he who threatened Brigida, and it was he who murdered the Baron, and you can bet it's he who's keeping Maria a prisoner somewhere.
Shandor Corvin was pronounced dead. That case was closed.
But his body was never recovered, was it?
Do you know how many people meet their end in the Danube? And half the bodies are never recovered.
It's Corvin who's been haunting this opera house for years, waiting for his moment of revenge.
We considered that possibility. The day the Baron was murdered, I sent my men out looking for Corvin on the odd chance that he was still alive.
You found no one, did you?
Mm-mm. Which confirms my belief that he's dead.
Then, damn it, look for him among the dead.
You think he's living in a graveyard?
No. He's gone deeper than the grave. In the old myth, Orpheus went into the depths of hell to look for his lost love. Now, why else would Corvin use that name unless he, too, is living in some underground hell?
Yeah, we'll keep looking for the girl. If we find her, we'll be in touch.
Listen to this.
Let me go, I'll return.
I want to leave, but why? Why? I'm not evil, believe me. In my heart, I'm good. Now that you are safe, my work is done. Now I want to live like all the others. I want to have a woman and walk with her on Sundays. Our life will begin now. Believe me. Only love me. Don't be afraid. I only have to be loved. To be good. To see it. See it. Look at me. Look at me. Don't turn around. Look at me. You want to see what's behind it? Perhaps another mask. A mask behind a mask. No, no. You cannot tear this one off. That's me. 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 Give me your hand. Touch it. Touch it. It's me. Me. It's real. It's not a different mask. It's not a different mask. It's me. Me. It's a ghost who loves you. A ghost that adores you. Now I must haunt you always.
I didn't want to hurt you.
Weep for yourself. Up till now, there was a chance that I might let you go free. But now, since you've seen my face, there's no chance anymore. You would leave me forever. A woman that has seen me like this belongs to me. To me! To me! I'll never let you go. Never. Never.
We will spend our lives together, you and I. Poor Maria. My fate is your fate.
I remember when they built the sewer. Lots of old chambers were sealed off once they weren't needed. Storerooms for pickaxes and explosives. Now, when they built the opera, they had to put the foundation right on top of the central storage chamber. Quite an engineering feat it was.
So, if this plan is correct, this chamber is directly under the opera house here.
The plan is absolutely correct.
There may have been changes when the sewer was made.
If there had been any revisions, then they would have been filed here.
Would you please check that? It's important.
I don't know. It's been a very long day.
Vitally important.
I'm Maria Gianelli.
Are you so sure of that? Look. When her remains are dredged from the Danube in your clothes, police will list her corpse as that of Maria Gianelli. Now let me hear you sing. Let me hear you sing. Disobey me and I'll kill Michael Hartnell. I only let him live because of you. Leos! It's time to bring Maria Gianelli to a river grave. Watch her, Leos, like dragon's gold.
Maria. 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 It's all right. It's me, Michael. Come on, let's go. Come on now, it's all right. That's it. Right, come on. Shh, quiet. Please, Maria, you have to listen to me. Come on, good. That's right.
Worry, madam. If Corvin's in that sewer, my men will find him.
He's not there.
How can you be so sure?
He's finished with the underworld now. But he'll do everything in his power to find Maria again. If she goes to the opera, he'll be there seeking her. That's the place to trap him.
And I'm to be the bait?
I'm afraid so.
But we could protect you.
I don't understand. He loved life.
He's a madman. His love kills.
Se l'enfer qui t'appelle, c'est l'enfer.